Being a female firefighter, actually being a woman in any job that's dominated mostly by men, you're going to have to prove yourself. That is a given. Because I was breaking into a man's world. So as a woman going into a man's job, you have to have thick skin. You have to be able to roll with the punches, I guess. And I find I'm always proving myself, which is fine because that's how I am anyways. I always do a good job. And I'm tough. So I can take what they give me. And you have to give it back. And why did I want to do it? Because I thought, there's no women firefighters. And let's do it. I never wanted to give up. I had drive. And the drive was to show to myself that I could do it. I bawled. I was happy. It was a milestone. It was exciting, and there was a lot of press all the time, and every fire I went to, they had to take pictures of the girl. So that was kind of exciting, and my mom made a scrapbook, and she has all the articles and pictures. It was a proud moment. My family was really proud. I work with 170 men, and I would put my life in their hands any day. They're my family, because I spend a lot of the time with them. And I hope they feel the same about me. Firefighting isn't all about Backdraft, the movie. But let me tell you, when we get a call for a fire, adrenaline rush is like 90. You all of a sudden develop this strength that you never knew you had. You develop the courage. You get the insight. You get the intuitions of what you have to do in order to fight that fire. When I was hired onto night shift. It was my first shift. And we had my first call. The first, very first call was to the Oshawa Center for alarms ringing. But I was like pumped. Because it's your first call. You're like, holy smokes, man. What is going on? So we got back. And then my second call, which I say is my first call because it was my real eye-opener to what I actually have to do. It was the house explosion on French Street. It was a drug lab, and when we pulled up, it was looked like a dollhouse. The whole front of the building was off. You could see the floors and the rooms, and I was freaking scared, but like I said, the adrenaline kicked in. I got off the truck. My training kicked in. I knew what I had to do, and we were there all night long until we got the call probably 11 at night, and we were there till 8 in the morning. So that was my first real test of working and no sleep and then coming back to work the next day at 5:30, so it was a good rush. My first real medical call that was hard was an 18-year-old boy was hit by a car. And he didn't make it, he died in my arms. So that was tough. And that was 15 years ago. My favorite thing about firefighting would have to be helping people, like when they need me. Fighting fires are awesome, but actually comforting people who might have lost a family member, yeah, that gives me, it lifts my heart. My mom and I opened a store April 1st in 2009. We're downtown Oshawa, called J&C Stained Glass. Now, we opened it in Oshawa because it's a cute little downtown, and, you know, there's nothing like this in Oshawa. The closest store, the other store, is Whitby, and we thought, let's do it downtown instead of a mall somewhere to hopefully, you know, help the downtown core. Help to rebuild the downtown, I guess, by bringing in different shops. So my family and I live in Oshawa. I was born in Oshawa. I live at home with my better half, Adam, and we have a daughter named Ryan, and we have a 7-year-old boy named Jack. Do I find it tough balancing everything? Yes, I do. There's days sometimes I do feel guilty because I feel like I work too hard and I'm not giving everybody the attention they need. So that's tough. I also bring Ryan to the store with me. It's another option that I have so that Adam can have a day off or a break. Hi, pretty. Hi, pretty girl. She likes it at the store. Every year we have to do first aid CPR. When the winter comes, we have to be prepared for cold water rescue. When the spring comes, we do swift water rescue. We do auto X every year because we're always getting new equipment. We do live fire training. We do tons of medical training, first aid and CPR, because the techniques are always changing. Should women be firefighters? Absolutely. Only if they want the job. Only if they have the passion and the drive. And you have to love your job. If I can do it, anybody can do it. You have to be tough. Show them you're tough, girls. I just want to make sure women know that they can do whatever the hell they want to do. Any little negativity you might have about doing it, thinking you can't, or you're not strong enough, or you're not smart enough, you are. And you can do it. Set your mind to it, and you've got it.